Hey guys, RPM here. All right, so Caspa has been the talk of the town for the past couple weeks here due to its profitability. And you can see here that the network hash rate for Caspa has been pretty much gradually going up since the beginning of this month, November 1st, I would say, at around 162 terahash. And here we are today as of recording, it's 456 terahash. So that's a lot of hash rate that has been coming online over the past month, this whole month of November. And obviously we've been talking about it, and we've been getting more, you know, efficiencies on your AMD GPUs and NVIDIA GPUs, either using BZ Miner or LOL Miner. And we've been really happy about that over the past couple weeks here. But I'm going to say that pretty soon we are probably not going to be happy how profitability is going to be for Caspa in the coming bit here. I'm not quite sure when these E300 14 gigahash ASIC miners, they look like an ASIC miner, but they're FPGAs, and they do 250 watts at 14 gigahash. So that is an efficiency of, I think, 56 megahash per watt, which is, I think, almost 50 or 60 times more than an RTX 3070. So that's way more efficient than a GPU, right? An RTX 3070, if you guys can understand that. So I did contact these guys, and I haven't gotten a response yet, but I'm hoping to either get one for review or remote in to test one. So we'll see how that goes. So I'll dive into this a little bit later. But, you know, Caspa has been something that has been out now for, I think, more than 7 months, six or seven months. And Son of a Tech was the first guy to talk about it, and he's been talking about it over the past 7 months here, and he is the one that's been pretty much understanding the technicals and the fundamentals of Caspa being, you know, sound, and, you know, it's a good coin, and now everyone is jumping onto it to mine, including myself. I'm going to give props to Mr. Son of a Tech here, as this is a coin, right, that has jumped up in price, and it has also gone up in network hash rate and noise marketing. Just everyone is talking about it now because essentially it is profitable. That's it. That's basically it. I mean, that really goes to show, like, any of these new proof of work coins that came out this year. If you guys also remember Neoxa, you know, that came out a couple months ago, you know, that was also the most profitable coin for, you know, a couple weeks until everyone started moving over to it. And now here we are today. Caspa is still profitable, I would say, but it's going to come to a point depending on your electrical cost. I think anyone that's above 12 cents per kilowatt hour is not profitable. So just example, my RTX 3070 rig, I can get about 3.8 gigahash at about 667 watts, all right, the whole rig. And so that is not profitable. I'm minus 12 cents at 12 cents per kilowatt hour. So if I went to like 10 cents per kilowatt hour, for instance, then it would be 20 cents. So it used to be a lot better. But because if we're looking at the network hash rate for Caspa, it has been going up. But the price has dipped over the past 2 days here. So if we look here, Caspa has gone down a little bit here from almost, let's say, almost a cent down to 0.008 of a cent there. So it's coming down now. All right. So as people are figuring out, hey, Caspa is profitable, obviously, for people that I think, but I'm going to just be honest here. Majority of you guys that are watching, or majority of people that around the world, probably don't have 10 cent per kilowatt hour anymore. I know that majority of people around the world, electrical rates have been going up. And so it's probably, or hasn't been feasible for you to mine Caspa anyway. So as the network difficulty, the hash rate is going up for Caspa, you know, the equilibrium of the profitability on what to mine here, it's going to go down. And especially with this E300 that has been noted, I've been reading some Reddit posts about it. And apparently the Osprey Electronics, okay, just mind you, I don't know if this is real. Okay, OspreyElectronics.io. So take this with a grain of salt, but I've just been reading here, says 4 days ago, we are the manufacturer of the E300. Next batch is already booked, but please leave a message on our website and they will put you on a wait list. We are working on securing more Xilinx FPGA chips. Okay, so this E300, which I remember doing a video almost, 3 weeks ago. And we did see that there are the C1100 FPGAs that can do, it says, say, 4.3 gigahash at about 120 watts. And then there are the E300. I had a screenshot here 3 weeks ago of the E300. Now, I wonder if this is a single, this guy here, this whole E300, looks like it has three FPGA boards. So if you look at this part, it really looks like an ASIC, honestly. But if you look at that, right, and then you look at the screenshot of the miner, of Team Red Miner here, you can see 5.05 gigahash on each board. So that's almost 15 gigahash for this whole thing. And it didn't say the power consumption here, but if this equates to this E300, then that must be it. And I actually saw a video, Osprey Electronics actually has a YouTube channel here. So they posted this on November 13th of the E300 miner made by Osprey Electronics. So apparently you can also mine ETC at 210 megahash, but Caspa at 14 gigahash. So you can see the E300 miner, the web GUI here. All right, just playing the little thing here. And you can change the fan speeds, fan curve, miner configuration. Look at that, Team Red miner. So I don't know. All right, I mean, nobody knows how many of these Osprey Electronics E300s are going to come online. How many of these are going to basically turn on and take over the network hash rate, right? The network of Caspa, and just basically destroy all the GPU miners. And, you know, we just don't know. But at this point in time, obviously, I don't think it's happened yet, because I think a lot of GPU miners are moving over towards Caspa because it's profitable, right? So I don't think a lot of these E300s are on yet, but I guess we'll see, right? I guess we'll see. We'll follow the network hash rate and obviously wait until I maybe get a response from Osprey and see when these will eventually come out, right? And looks like they also sell the Varium C1100, right? This thing can also mine Caspa, right? This is just a heatsink. Never mind. $100 for a C1100. Damn, I'd buy like 12 of these right now. Okay, so I just wanted to also show, you know, how a lot of miners are mining Caspa, right? So on Mining Pool Stats right now, you can see a lot of people are on woollypoolie.com. Obviously, people should decentralize the hash rate. But looking at this, there's over 100,000 miners. And these are wallet-like addresses, not like, you know, specific miners. And so there is also 19,000 K heavy hash miners on NiceHack. NiceHash. And you can see there's 19, almost 20 terahash on NiceHash here on their algorithms list here. So a lot of people mining on NiceHash, and NiceHash is probably going to maybe bring down the price here, because that's going to put pressure on basically the markets of exchanging Caspa into BTC, or let's just go to markets here on CoinMarketCap. Let's see, they can trade into USDT on these exchanges and BTC on TradeOgre. Okay, so I'm assuming NiceHash does have some sort of exchange account on TradeOgre, and or maybe these USD accounts, and they're trading it into Bitcoin, whatever. This is going to put pressure on the Caspa price for sure. Now, if that is also going to help with the volume or liquidity, we will never know what the market making is going to be for Caspa on these exchanges. But it's interesting to see that Caspa has been going up since the beginning of November, and it's been essentially really profitable. And now that we are having a dip here, I feel like things are potentially maybe cooling off. And I think as we get a little bit more network hash rate here, mining for those that are at 10 cents or less are not going to be profitable. So I don't think it's going to last very long, especially with these E300s that are potentially coming out. I heard like end of this month or maybe beginning of December. So if these start shipping out, you know, how many of these do they have, right? That's the biggest question. I'm not quite sure how many of these are going to be on the network for mining Caspa. And it's interesting that Team Red Miner comes out with updates to add. They just added support for the CVP-13. This is another notorious FPGA, and the VCU, BCU, other FPGA boards. And it's just looks like they said here, renamed the E300 to E335C. In preparation for supporting additional FPGA devices on E300 boards. So looks like Team Red Miner is really going hard here in supporting FPGAs for mining. All right. So, I mean, FPGAs are something that, you know, has always been hard to get. It's always been a closed, I would say, ecosystem. A lot of miners or Bitstream developers are pretty private, and they sell it for a lot of money to bigger FPGA farms. And there's a whole thing about that. Anyways, I've been mining Caspa profitably for, I don't know, the past couple of weeks here on a few rigs. Should I have mined it back when Son of a Tech mined it? Yeah, Son of a Tech did his research, knew that this coin would do really, really well, and it did. But it goes to show that there are a lot of other coins that we just don't know that could go up in price in the future, right? Nobody knows, right? Same thing happened with Nyoxa. Nyoxa was also profitable when we all talked about it. And then the Meow coin at one point was a little bit profitable until everyone mined it, and then it's not profitable anymore. The same idea is happening, I think, with Caspa here. It's hitting a point where it's not going to be profitable anymore. And then now, I think another coin that people are bringing up is Radiant. So same thing. If I made a dedicated video talking about Radiant being the most profitable coin, it wouldn't be the next day. Everyone would flock over to it and it's done. Really, there's zero point in talking about, you know, those types of videos now. I've tried to refrain from talking about profitability, maybe doing efficiency of the coin. That's it. And like doing a little bit of showing what to mine. But, you know, my titles, my videos, I will never have like, oh, this coin is the most profitable or whatever. I don't want to persuade people just because of that, right? Because of that. I'm more so like the mining side of it and getting the most efficient clocks you can for your GPUs. That is what makes sense. But for those that mined Caspa early on, 7-6 months ago with the CPUs, congratulations to you. You probably did really well, assuming you sold, but maybe a lot of people are thinking that Caspa could be a long-term hold, and yeah, you could be right, you could be wrong, nobody knows, we'll see how that goes. So anyways, my friends, let me know your thoughts on what you think about Caspa and what I just talked about in this video, and if you think that it will be dominated by the, you know, FPGAs. A lot of the FPGAs, I guess, can mine Caspa now. Honestly, by reading Team Red Miner, allowing a lot of support for FPGAs. So interesting enough, I guess I do have an FPGA myself. I have the FK33. Now, I don't know if that would be able to mine Caspa. Maybe that's something I could try. FK33, FPGA, FK33. Oh, looks like there's support for the FK33. Wow, let me try that. Oh, maybe I can mine Caspa on my Forest Kitten 33. All right, well, I'll figure that out in another video. All right, I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a good one. Peace out.